Hi, I'm Valda Beebe. I'm the host and a visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Good morning, Dallas. Thank you so much for staying with me this morning. And as I told you, I'm back with my next guest. I'll be speaking with Brian Galvin. He is the Chief Academic Officer at Varsity Tutors. Brian, welcome to the Valda Beebe Show for the first time.
Hey, good morning, Valda. Thank you for having me.
Okay, so you're here to help my audience navigate the COVID-19 academic slide. What is that?
Yeah, good question. So I think it relates to the summer slide. In a typical summer, if it's 8 to 10 weeks long, students lose about 20% of their previous year's gains in reading and 30% of those gains in math. Well, this year, it was a longer summer for most school districts. It was a shakier spring leading into it, so not all skills were covered as thoroughly or as well as in previous years. And then there's all the challenges with learning online, remote learning, and all those things. So the COVID slide is kind of the combined weight of those three factors. And as families are getting report cards or having parent-teacher conferences, I think a lot of families are recognizing students started the year a little bit behind, and it's a challenge to catch up.
Okay, so how are you measuring this slide? Just because of past summer performances, you know what the slide is?
No, we're kind of custom measuring that for families right now. We have our Learning Lab tool. We've had over 60,000 students across the country take diagnostic assessments since July 1st, so sort of measuring back-to-school readiness or kind of early school year readiness. And that's given us over 1 million data points to draw some conclusions and even build, you know, small group classes specific to the skills that students are struggling with most. So, for example, we've found that for pretty much every grade level, there are some foundational, really important skills that students will build on this year where more than half of students started the school year behind. So, for example, in, you know, 4th, 5th, and 6th grade, a lot of that relates to divisibility and fractions. And what kind of concerns us is that that's what builds on, you know, algebra builds on, you know, divisibility and factoring concepts, and then higher level math builds on algebra. What we really want to address is not let this snowball from, you know, we started the year a little bit shaky, and then, you know, it was a challenge and those skills built on it, and all of a sudden a student feels like, hey, I'm not a math person, when really it's just a case of we're building on shaky fundamentals. We need to work harder this year to shore up those fundamentals so kids are ready for what comes next.
Okay, so they need to work harder. We're a couple of months into the school year. So what should families be doing?
We look at it as kind of a three-step process. One is just acknowledge that the COVID slide is real, and this year will require a little bit more work and ingenuity. Step two is to diagnose. You know, kids are already frustrated with learning remotely and not being able to go to school with their friends and all the other fun things that you know, physical school has. So if we're going to ask them to work harder, if we're going to ask parents to work a little bit harder, let's diagnose specifically which skills each student needs to work on that are critical paths to this year. And then step three is to supplement. You know, we need to, you know, to bring in outside resources. We're not adding more hours to the school day. And so, you know, we need to supplement, whether it's through tutoring, through, you know, adaptive online self-study, through small group classes, you know, find resources that specifically address what each student needs to overcome so that they're ready for the new information this year.
Tell me about Varsity Tutors and what you guys offer to all of these matrix of challenges you've talked about.
Sure. Happy to. We are the largest live learning platform in the country. We have over 40,000 tutors teaching in over 3,000 subjects. And for specifically for the COVID slide, we have completely for free that Learning Lab tool, which can help parents diagnose, you know, what their students need to work on this year and really distill it to foundational concepts. So it builds a custom learning plan that parents can work through with students, or you can outsource to a tutor. So that's completely free. We're also using that data. You know, we mentioned we've been diagnosing this all summer and fall to set up small group classes that in, you know, 2, 3, 4 sessions really deep dive on specific skills, something like factoring or, you know, finding common denominators, those specific things that we know, you know, 2/3 of students are struggling with and that will be critical paths this year so that, you know, students can really deep dive on specifically what they need. And we're adding new classes all the time. And then, of course, it's in our name, Varsity Tutors. We've got one-on-one tutors that not only provide families with expertise for their learners, but I think sometimes just we're asking so much of parents this year, you know, to be parents, to be disciplinarians of, you know, you're basically the principal's office of, you know, the school that's happening in your home. You can outsource some of that expertise and just have someone else's voice tell your kids, you know, hey, you really need to brush up on that homework, or you really need to put in some time before Friday's test. You know, tutoring can be really helpful just to absolve parents of some of that responsibility, time, and patience that we know is all running thin.
Online, where do they go?
Find us at varsitytutors.com.
All right. This has been very helpful, Brian. Galvin, thank you for being my guest.
Hey, thank you for the opportunity.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is My Phone Pouch. My Phone Pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.